Hello everyone and welcome back to Sousa Plays, even though we didn't get to play much in the last video. It's Nurgle and Blood Bowl and we have tons of extra money. We're actually giving up 210 team value right now in just cash, meaning our team value is 2130. I think that's about the highest I've ever had on a team. Might have been a little bit higher on one of my offline teams, had a very high team value, but not in this league. We are going to have a little bit more as well because Scuffle leveled up, so at least 20 more. Yes, we have block, we have mighty blow, was that it? Yes, we need more guard, we need more claw. I think we need guard more than claw right now, so we're going to get guard first here. So now we have two guard warriors, which is pretty good. And these need block. I think we need block here and maybe another guard here. And then claw on these two, of course. Mighty blow first and then claw there. Looking pretty good. Don't really need anything else, except for more SPP on the warriors to get them all set up. Claw, mighty blow, block, and guard. But other than that, it's going very well. 27.5. Who could have guessed that? I think we were at 5.65 or something. 5.64 at least. And after that, it's been smooth sailing. Mostly because our opponent seems to be conceding all the time. Well, 165 seconds. I'm keeping all the money because I want to get level 4 stadium. Might even keep it just to have a really high team value. Because, well, I don't know. Doesn't seem like people want to play a Nurgle team at 2150. I mean, they could take the time and look and see that it's all money. But they don't. Anyway, I'll bring you back once we find somebody. And we ran into a very high level Chaos. Well, hopefully he'll be scared, but I don't think so. This might be the end of our little experiment here. But we'll have a look at our opponent's team and see if he is likely to give us a quick concede. But if all that steam value is actually relevant, then we are going to have a tough time. I probably don't want to play a game where I give up this much advantage against a very high level opponent. So we might have to spend this money in inducements instead. Well, I could look now, but it's only going to bring me back to this screen whenever he is ready to play. So I'll wait, and there we go, let's have a look then. Minotaur. That's not the best. One coach assist, one cheerleader. Minotaur is level 6. Also has niggling injury. Blodge. Foul appearance. Stand firm. Claw. No guard. Claw Mighty Blow. Pylon. Claw Mighty Blow. Pylon Pro Frenzy. On the Chaos Warriors, this is. Jump up as well. Very dangerous Chaos Warrior. This one has a tail and tackle, so I guess he's the one who deals with dodgers. His killer is actually injured, so he we're lucky there, but his killer is actually not injured, and then he has his killer also not injured. So yeah, ball handler, sneaky git foul, sneaky git dirty player, Not much guard though, but we don't have the guard to overwhelm him. He only has one bench. I don't feel too good about this. We're gonna use our petty cash at least. A bribe perhaps? A bribe and a babe? Okay, babe and bribe. Let's see if that's enough to discourage him. He has so many pylon guys, so bribe seems good. Keep the rest of the money. Giving up, how much is that? 180k, about a wizard, a little bit more than a wizard. Don't recommend it. I should have checked his record. No one has Finn. Expect him to start on offense. ...100%. This many Claw and Mighty Blow and Pylon, you probably want to take all the hits you can. Now who do we put on the line against this guy? Everybody has Claw, so it doesn't matter if you have Armor 9. We put the beast up there so he has a tougher time getting the hits. Or do we just go with our rotters? I do want my dirty player on the field. But I kinda need these low value guys to be the guys on the line. Then again, if they actually survive, it's great, isn't it? I think I'm gonna allow him to hit and pile on my beasts. He's gonna blitz one of these as well. Let's put the kicker in one of the sides. The frenzy is probably not gonna be the most important here. Something like this, our claws on the side. There we are. These type of matchups are usually decided by who gets the punch first. But maybe we can get lucky and he won't break all of these. Two armor breaks, one knockout, one stun. Would be average, I'd say. And by the knockout could be an injury as well. I left my wrestler on the sideline. He does have a few dodge. I guess wrestle could have been good to deal. Well, he doesn't have block actually on his ball carrier. Strong arm though, so he gets a plus one when he passes long passes. Not sure who he's passing to. Looks like he wants to hit the Minotaur with his the beast with his Minotaur, and then it does look like he's not gonna do that. This Chaos Warrior with Pile On, Mighty Blow, Claw, Block, and Jump Up. He got Jump Up first, so he definitely wanted to make him a Pile On guy. And finally, at 76 SPP, he got Pile On. And he's been living well since then. Is there any more injuries we need to look out for? I know that this guy has a movement injury. Is that all he has? Yes. I know the Minotaur had a niggle. Is that one niggle or two? It's two. Okay, good to know. So the Minotaur is actually a very juicy target to hit. Okay, and he didn't really put anyone back. I'm gonna go for a long kick. Maybe we can steal it. Not that that matters much. The weather is not gonna matter at all. Good kick. Tail's gonna make it harder to dodge from him, but we don't really have anyone who suffers a lot from not being able to dodge. Dirty player, double Double pile. Didn't break, he's gonna pile on. There's the pile on animation. And knockout. So then one knockout he got. On our dirty player. Too bad, I wanted to use him to foul. Now we're gonna have to foul with someone valuable if we want to foul. He might not get a chance to foul in this first half, because if we get down three players here, then we're never gonna get in an opportunity to get a decent foul off. Second armor break. It's stun or knockout. It's knockout. Is it piling on knockout? He's not. Okay, so two guys down. Now the beast. Push. I'll take a push. He rerolls it into push. And do not use the stand firm. No way. Push me away from you. Good. Gonna take more hits. Beast is now freed up. He can blitz somebody. We lost our two rotters. Only knockouts though. And I did buy a babe. So he's gonna get a 3 die? No, it's only a 2 die. Not sure why he put an assist up there. Maybe to protect the pylon afterwards. Just a push. Can't reroll. You already used this reroll. Ah, frenzy. That's why. So he's gonna be next to us, but he's probably piling on here, so it doesn't matter. This is a good foul. But he might bring people up. Okay, good. He didn't break. Double ones. So now is it time to consider the ball? No, not yet. First foul. Try to move the minnow. 50%. Doesn't feel like it. Picks up the ball. It's a 2 plus because he has extra arms, giving him a plus 1. Also sure hands. This dodge guy is going to be a receiving threat. I wouldn't mind if he tossed a pass there, so I'm not inclined to try to mark him or anything. I might go up here. That's his guy, right? That's a pretty juicy foul. Okay, so who do we blitz? I wouldn't mind him scoring quickly here so we can get to our drive. No assist on the beast. Minotaur has blodge. Hitting him maybe, and then fouling this guy. So we want to rush in there. He's gonna foul us back though. That's not great. Don't want to give him any extra hits. No, we probably foul. We blitz him. Stand up here. This guy out here. Assist on the beast. Where do we want to put the beast? Here maybe? No. There maybe? And then bring my frenzy in the middle. This here is now okay. additional dodge. We need to follow the pylon. Unless it's a knockout. There's a knockout. Now we need to dodge here, unfortunately. Would like to foul here, but I don't really have anyone good to foul with. That's not dead. Gets his guard in. For a hit on the rotter. Just a push. Good for us. Means that this foul is less likely. Now we can get two assists in here and get a one die on the beast, which might be useful. He's close enough to prevent, well, not prevent. Oh, the Minotaur moved on his own. But he doesn't have guard. He doesn't need guard there, I suppose. Ah, he's blitzing beasts. Just a push. Reroll it. He rerolls it. Gets the pow. I'm gonna not use Stand Firm again. Because it gets me further away from the foul. I guess he could push me there, but if he follows up then there's no one who could come in and foul. With no way into it. Pushes me straight back instead. Piling on. Claw mighty low. Worth it. Gets a success and a knockout. Too bad. That's three out against one. Definitely looking really bad. But if it's only knockouts, we could still get back in the second half. If we can deal some permanent damage on our hits, it would be awesome. But he has so many more players that can actually deal damage. He's still up there, that means he's probably marking him then. We might be able to assist that with our... Our killer is marked. But we can free him up. Oh, he's surrounding him. He's probably not moving forward unless we put some pressure on him, and we can't really afford that because we don't have the number. Oh, he is moving forward. Never mind. Still can't reach him though. I think he'll stand up over here. Probably not, no. Okay, so we have a claw hit there. Would free him up. Could blitz him. And then mark here and hit him. There's three mighty blow hits on armor's. Armor 8 or claw, or with claw. A mark here. And he can switch to any side he wants, so maybe we don't pressure him just yet. This needs to be a knockdown. Yes. And follow. It's actually a GFI now that I look at it. Let's put our tackle on his dodge. Then we try to get this guy with one GFI. Reroll the GFI if it fails. I'll reroll that too. Damn it, that means we can't pile on either. I need to get away because he just jumps up and hits me. So let's do that. And you can hit him. Oh. Well, this is a terrible turn. Let's try fouling then. 3 assists. Can I have a bribe? From a 6, we break it, but only a stun and cost us our bribe. As usual, the bribe's gone first try. At least then we don't have to worry about it. This is probably a good time to concede, actually, if you're trying to play this game yourself. You should definitely concede if you don't get a better start than this. We've seen 4 players concede against us so far. Let's see if Foul Appearance can do anything. Nope. And he gets the knockdown. And the armor break. Just a stun, but that's gonna be fine. And a knockout. 4 knockouts. Well, it's not permanent damage, so still the second half could be good, but we're gonna have to survive a lot of hits here in the first. At this point we should probably just pull away and try to wait for second half. We get 2 chances to wake up if he scores, and he probably will. But since we can't dodge, we're gonna have to take all the hits. His Minotaur moves every time, except the first time. So I guess he's moved 2 out of 3. Every time. Is he moving the ball carrier in here? See, this is where we should have had our wizard. Could try to hit this guy, he's gonna try to dodge. And a GFI. No problem. Pass the ball to him, please. Ball carrier goes in here, maybe. There we could actually get a 2 die on him. So, well, this guy hasn't moved yet, so he's moving up here then. Or not. Do we want to send someone in here on a suicide mission and knock the ball loose? I mean, it could get us a win. It has to have some value, right? So we'd want to hit with our killer. We'd need to tie this guy up. We'd also need to sacrifice someone to him. Frenzy guy. That's a bit far. Kicker. I guess we send the kicker in. We could put this guy here and make a hit on him. Taking more hits than I should here. Of course it's a push, why wouldn't it be? Let's stay here so I can push the ball carrier this way. Maybe the ball bounce to this side if we get lucky. Okay. Get lucky. We got him. I'm gonna have to pile this on, otherwise I'm gonna get punched by 100 people. On the ground, at least, he gets sent off if he kicks us, and he can only do it once. Stirring presence, bounce, stirring presence, the Minnow got it. Well, that's not ideal for our opponent. So we don't really want to put anyone next to the minion so he can blitz his way out. We want him to be able to dodge. It would be nice to have an armor break. He's free. Stunning presence reaches here. Doesn't reach over here though. Still think we do this. Keep our frenzy free so he can ABB safety. We can just hand it off to him. Well, actually no, we can't do that because of all the disturbing presence. So scoring with the ball on the Minotaur isn't very easy, of course. He only moves on a 50% chance if he's not hitting anyone. And if he's carrying the ball, you don't really want to be hitting with him. And there's also the loner issue. Okay, that's lucky. Can't really afford to reroll that. So the sacrificed Rotter survives. Brought his scoring threat away as well. We didn't fall for that. We would like to score on that Chaos Warrior for sure, but it's not gonna happen. So we could blitz him away and then try to move the minion forward, but it's only a 50% chance that he moves. chance that he moves. There we go. We tried to hit with him. Got a wild animal. So he's gonna be standing there with the ball. Did he use his blitz for that? I don't think he did. No, he still has the blitz. He's gonna go for our 4 strength. No carrier. No luck there. Reroll? Probably not. You're gonna need your rerolls with the ball on the Minotaur. And he has a follow-up for a one die with wrestle. Not got that one either. Sadly, he has block on everybody, so it's not turnovers. Stands him up. Chain push is available. Foul there, there's only a one assist. Because all the others are marked. And minus one because of him. So it would be a straight up no assist foul. One dice a skull. Was he free on that skull? No. He knows he can't spend the reels. Stun. Could be helpful. So does this warrior have guard? It does not. I could do this. Hit here. Get a push. Get an assist. Then I'd have two assists here. Does any of these have guard? No. So then I could blitz the Minotaur with a 2-guy. But he has blodge though, so it's not very good. I might actually want to leave the ball in the Minotaur. Okay, thank you. Get the guard out of here. Follow in. This is so dangerous. He's gonna get a ton of extra hits on me. Knock this guy out first. Good. Stay, actually. Okay, get lucky now. Pow, please, pow. Another pow. Can't waste a real moment. Stand firm. Not stand firm. Fair enough. We'll try this hit, of course, since we have a 2-die here. armor break or two would be nice. Standing him here wouldn't be very good. His guards over there. Can we get some armor breaks? Oh, nice one. How's this gonna work? I can push him. I can push this guy away, but that doesn't really matter. I'm gonna push in here. I could push the Minotaur. That doesn't matter either. I'm gonna push this guy over here. That means he can't hit my killer. And stay to mark him? I think it's fine. He's gonna get hit anyway. Better have an extra guy on him in case he wants to blitz there. Actually, I'm standing there, he can't move out this way. Actually, he could do that, right? Now we have guard there, but if he blitzes, he could blitz with the Minotaur this way. So we need to be here. But now he could blitz the Minotaur this way. Oh, that's even worse. Should have put him there, maybe. That would have been a better spot. Well, we still only have one removal. This is four, so we're down three players. Kind of weird that we were able to put this much pressure on. It was mostly because of his poor last turn where he only got pushes and blocks. And also due to the fact that he actually has only one guard on the field. We did manage to remove one of his guards, so we have two guards versus one right now. Which effectively gives us another player, almost, you could say. Yeah, at least when everybody is standing in a big blob like this. So if the Minotaur goes here, gets a push and then a knockdown, he could then be free to move. If he's blitzing, that is. And he blitzes with strength 6, so there's really nothing you can do to prevent it. Dodging, is that what you want to do? I guess he wants to go this way. No, he wants to hit that guy. He wants to hit the killer. He doesn't really care about scoring. Oh, there goes the killer. I guess that's game. That's a knockout. Yep, it's a knockout. Five knockouts. No injuries. The Minotaur can still hit, of course. It's only a one die down here. So 4, 5, 6, 6. It's a one die on him as well. Takes the one die. Wow. With the ball carrier. Gets the push that he wanted. And now he wants the power. Perfect. Dodges his ball carrier away. And our five players on the field. Six, we have him as well. He could one die there to push him loose and then blitz the moose. Push him loose, blitz the moose. This is a better die. Let's take that first. Maybe, just maybe, we could break the armor of one of these goats? No. Okay, well, let's go down there. Stand you up. I'm gonna try that one die push. Can we make it a two die? No. You can tie this guy up, because he's most likely to pick the ball up if we knock it loose. One die, we need a knockdown. Push we'll have to do. Might as well go here since we have to dodge anyway. Let's see if we can dodge. Oh, he has foul appearance. Of course our dodge fails. He made like two or three. Okay, we made it on the second try, but now we don't have a reroll for this. But we got the pal. So the ball's gonna go down. On the ground. Didn't catch it. It's in two of our tackles zone. Let's try to pick it up. Great. Okay. He might go down and go over here. He can get up. 5, 6. Probably get hit anyway. I don't want to stand next to the minnow though. Okay, well, we could maybe delay this a little bit. Hopefully no more removals. Oh, he's on break again. That's where he gets claw on everybody. Just a stun, but the pylon makes it into knockout. Well, I kinda wish I'd gotten a second babe. Didn't know that it'd all be knockouts. Of course, we have a 50-50 chance to recover from injury as well, but there hasn't been any of those. Goes in there. Well, he wants to hit him. That's not going to get him a shot at the ball. He doesn't have anyone who can move that far. Does he? Well, he got the knockdown. I guess if he gets a knockdown here, push here. And if he stays on the field, Not when you have claw on everybody. Knock out. Beautiful. So now he has a path through to blitz the ball carrier for two players. He needs the assist first. Jump up's gonna make it. So which one of these are going to do the hitting? Could try to stand the minnow up first, since he's not blitzing with him. Probably not dodging with him either. There goes the ball carrier. Injury, but recovered. So another removal. Ball's free. Could make two GFIs to pick it up. There's two rerolls, so there's no real risk. He's gonna wait. Now do you send the minotaur up? Seven guys out. Eight guys out. So we should have three players available. What can we do here? We have a one die blitz on the guy marking the ball. This Nurgle war is going down. This guy doesn't have mighty low or anything though. Ah, I freed up his ball cannon. This guy's actually free if he doesn't stand a minnow up. I'm not sure why he's not standing a minnow up. Well, now he did. And he stood up. This guy's free to move. I'm sure he wanted to foul, but there's actually no one to foul. They're already all gone. Well, since the minnow stood up, this move became much harder. We can do that. Get a 2 die. 67, 67. Or we can do this for a 1 die. And immediately get knocked down. Then do a 1 dodge, pick up into toss the ball over here maybe. This guy could be a scoring threat. I think I'll go for the 1 die. That won't knock the ball free though, so we should do it like this. Push is all we need. Actually no, a push is not very good. That closes up his dodge path. So we have to do that. Fail the pickup. Won't do all that. Could land with 2 taxes. So this looks like where he gets the ball back. And it can score on turn 8 pretty easily, but at least he can only hit one of us this turn. Looks like he's going for the warrior. Doesn't even matter that this guy... he's probably just surrounding him with a bunch of players so he can hit him on turn 8. Maybe he's setting up a push chain. This guy has frenzy, so he puts this guy here. And maybe someone here as well. Makes it a warrior so we can't just push him away. So that's set up so he can surf him on turn 8. Bit risky to surf someone on turn 8. Doesn't bother to make this a 3 die, takes the 2 die. Gets it. It's an outbreak. And a knockout, wow. Slightly unlikely to get this many knockouts. He must be fuming that he's not getting any injuries. The only injury he got, we regenerated. But we're gonna have to get pretty pretty lucky to get all 8 back with only a 3 plus chance. On average we should get 5 or 6 back. 6 is lucky, 5 is slightly unlucky. The Minotaur though, he's moved on 4 plus every time, except the first one. Now it's actually... Well, he failed actually to move on a 2 plus once. But he's made, let's see, 4 plus rolls. And the pickup there is easy now. We have 2 players on the field. We could try to dodge to get a better armor roll than if we try to if we let him hit us. I think I'll do this. No. This guy doesn't have mighty blow, so a punch from him is not as bad. And I don't think he'll be fouling on this turn. He probably can afford to hit this guy though, especially since he's at 3 die now. That's our kicker. We need him next off. No, wait. This was his off? At this point, he should probably pile on the knockdowns. Nope, he takes the knockout. Well, he knocked out 9 of our players and injured 1. So that was a pretty decent off. Is he going to try to hand off to the warrior? He has a reroll. It's a 1 in 9 that he fails it. It would be smart to put a guy next to him, just in case he fumbles it and it lands in his hands. Or he can fumble it back to him, even better. Well, that's fun. We have 2 chances to wake up, so actually we should get maybe all but 2 back here. That's a bit unlucky. We got all but 1. That is lucky. This guy stayed out. Well, he didn't have a babe, but still, that's pretty unlucky for him. So there, didn't do any damage to us. Only our best warrior stayed out. I'm not gonna complain that, our best warrior stayed out. So all in all, that drive was pretty ineffective. We did score on turn 8. But he didn't remove anyone, so we're going to have a full team in the second half. He has a full team too as well, of course. Watch, you're going to let me blitz this guy with my frenzy? No. He's probably putting everybody back there. Just deciding who to sacrifice. This guy seems like a good candidate. It would be great if we could get a removal here. But of course we only have 2 claws. Giving us the guard guy though. He's only guard now. Well, this guy might come back. Still, it seems to value his claws a lot more and his utility players. I'd probably put this guy on the line. Dirty player. Alright. Well, we can't hit those. We could put someone up in case we get... let's put these 2 up in case we get a riot and get another turn. Kicker, not that important right now. Let's see. This guy does not have blocks, so someone with blocks should hit him. I probably want to pile on the beasts with lock, with guard, because he's the most important to remove. That means you're hitting him, forcing him to use wrestle, and you're hitting lost. You hit in the middle, so who hits the first guy? Block would be nice, mighty blow would be better. Can we get a 3 die on him maybe? Not with him next to us. 5, 6, 7, we could. Put the beast there. And this, and this. And you need to be here to put in more assists. Okay. Minotaur kicking it. Nice weather again. So no riots, so we can't bring anyone forward to score. So I'm gonna make this a 3 die for the beasts. There was already a 3 die before that. Start with that. Good. Now I wanna do this. I shouldn't have followed with the beast actually. It was a misplay. Now we get the pylon. And the armor bar. We don't get the pylon, we injure him immediately. That's nice. No long term. Does he spend his reroll his apothecary on that? No. That probably would have been a decent idea. Okay, well, let's get it to a 3 die. Work. Knock out. Not bad. Do we try to... Oh, we spent our bribe. Yeah. Fouling this guy with dirty player. It's almost guaranteed that we get an honor break. Almost. Make it even better. I mean, he could get up there, but then he would have nowhere to foul without 2 GFI, so I don't want to do that. Oh, that's not our dirty player. Where's our dirty player? On the bench. My bad. I don't want to foul then. Particularly. Let's try to get 1 SPP on sure on White Pony. Might as well. Fair enough. We got the removal. And he has 2 wake-up rolls now. He needs to make one. He needs to make both to have a full team. We get our warrior back as well. That's good. Have to remember to put him on the field. And his guys... One woke up. Was it... Okay, it wasn't the warrior. So, the god warrior step out. And the god goat is also out. So both his guards are gone. This looks promising. He still has a lot of removal capability, of course, with all his claws and mighty blows. Probably leaves the minnow on the line. Be nice to get that minnow down with 2 niggling injuries. We don't need to roll a 6 to knock him out on the injury roll if we can break his armor. So we need a 9 to break the armor and then a 6 to knock him out. After we, of course, we need a pow to knock him down. If we can get a mighty blow pile on him, that would be awesome, but we'd have to roll a pow, and that's the tricky part. Okay, so who do we want most here? Don't like his jump ups. I'm gonna get caught by those, I'm sure. Again, this guy seems to be good at hitting him. The beast, I guess, could try to hit the minnow. Mighty blow here. Right, you should be on the field. So should you. Oh, I don't have anyone? Rather have dirty play than wrestle, I suppose. Especially if we can get the minnow down. Maybe he hits the minnow just to get him down. You blitz. Do I really want to blitz with him? No, I don't. I'll hit him with him. This guy blitzes here. More. You go in there, that's pretty good. Then we need some protection out here. You be in the middle. You can protect this side. Fowler, be ready to get in there. Okay. I need an assist up there too. Hmm. Where did I put my frenzy? No, that's his team. Okay. There's the Minnow kick again. We can stand underneath it. It's not in a great spot. I guess you go out and try to get it. No, and it landed on the sideline. Ooh, that's really annoying. Now we're gonna have to try and pick that up. We'll bring this guy out here to sort of protect this side. If we fail that, but then the ball could land anywhere, so it's not very good. Okay. Anyway, removals are important, so let's push. I am gonna follow that so I can have a good die on the Minotaur here. But I should hit this first. Because I want him there. And I want to follow. Well, if this is a removal, it doesn't matter. It is. But if it hadn't been a removal, then we would have been able to force the Minotaur to be pushed this way, and then we'd have a better foul on him. Now if I knock him down, he'd go back here, and the foul would be not that good. But we could make it decent. If we blitz him, that's actually pretty good. Okay, let's try it. Come on, knock down. Okay, well, we didn't need the tackle after all. Stand firm, please. He's not gonna stand firm. So we can't follow here because we need to foul through there. No one break. This does mean we could hit from here, I suppose, and then foul from there. That's good. East is free. I guess I'll move him out here. Get another assist up here. I guess that should be you. Then 1, 2, 3, 4 foul. I'm definitely fouling the Minotaur. Bring this guy back, actually. The foul is so good, I almost want to do it before I try to pick the ball up. ...83% double niggle, dirty player. On a Minotaur. Got him. Injury on a 9. So one niggle actually affected it. And we didn't get caught. Okay, let's not drop this over the sideline. We dropped it, but not over the sideline. I'll take that, actually. It's a bit unlucky to roll a 1 in 9 on an important pickup, but as long as it doesn't go out and then, ooh, tossed here, that would be pretty bad. I believe I read the rules for the throw-in. If the ball goes out here, then it is tossed in from the last space it was on the field, I believe. And then you roll a d6, where 1, 2 is this way, 3, 4 is this way, 5, 6 is this way. And then you roll 2 d6 for how far. So 2 would be here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the expected distance, which is half the field. And of course, if it goes here and lands here, then it gets thrown in again from the last space it was on the field. Ooh, we tried to get the beast with his blitz and got the front appearance. Probably wants to reroll it. Does. Gets knocked down. He didn't use pro either, he used an actual reroll. And knockout? Not yet. But we know what's coming. Hey, actually staying on the field. Beautiful. His Fowler comes in, 2 assists, 1 counter assist, and a GFI. Makes the GFI. 28% chance to break armor. Does not. Now we can punch his dirty goat. Still the issue of the ball not being in our hands, though. But he's down 3 players now. We have a full team without a scratch, except for a stun. If we can now start removing his claw bombers, it would be nice. But there's so many of them, so we might not be able to. This guy gets a mighty blow. I think we tried to save the beast, perhaps? Screen these off. Do we go for contact now? This is a 1 in 36, so that's probably the best start. I think I'll follow. No, possible. 4 strength here. We should have enough to mark most of these. Could keep going on a dirty player rampage, but I don't think that's very good. I'm planning on blitzing this guy. Need an assist. Now blitz him from here. Tempted, for sure. But I think we need our reroll. It's our drive. We need to score. So you can come back here and be. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we need you over here then. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we need to move you first. Guess you move up here. And now we definitely need to catch the ball. Could hit there first. This is okay. Cage is ready. Dirty player. Not doing much. I get him over. Actually, oh, that's too far. Here then. This guy is actually not doing anything. So I guess he could stand here. I kinda want him a little bit closer, but... Oh wait, that actually prevents me from getting to where I want to go. So I guess I'll put him here then, even worse. 2 die first, I think. It's a 1 in 9 either way. Would have made a pickup with that. This guy has jump up, so I'm not gonna stand next to him. Doesn't have jump up? He does not have jump up. This guy has claw though, so I don't want to stand next to him. And now we get into the cage. No, we double fail it and it goes out and it's thrown in to right in front of this guy. Well, that's kind of unlucky. Failing it twice. So the 4 was for direction and the 9 was for distance. So it was from here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and it bounced that way. What did we scatter it to here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and bounce this way. Yeah, that seems right for the 4. So the 4 is direction, and the 3 and 6 is distance. And then it scatters when it lands, of course. No, it should land there. The last place it was on the field is there, so that's where it starts. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 4 is down. Doesn't matter. He still has a pretty easy pickup. Still be in range of us, but well, he gets another pal. Actually, it is a break. But here he goes. That means we lose a guy on the field, and that's the worst of it. Gets an assist for this. It's still a one die, though. We could move this guy up, but then gives up the free chance at the touchdown he just got. We need to pick up extra arms on our player. Oh, a 6. Well, that's how you pick the ball up. 4, 5. We can get a 2 down here, no problem. Unless he makes him dodge. He's already used his blitz, so this guy can't blitz. Makes a dodge to get that 2 die. We made a lot of effort to get this 2 die, and got a push. Definitely not worth re-rolling. We have a 2 die back. But we need to blitz here, of course. I'm gonna put the beast here, mark these 2. We might run someone in to take a claw hit on the beast. So we'll put this guy here, maybe? Maybe just here. And you can't pick the ball up, really. You come over here, I suppose. No, not there. It doesn't really matter, I can hit it from there. this is the guy who's blitzing and I just blocked him. Like a champion. Okay, so I'm blitzing there, pushing to them. You come in the middle. I want you on the sideline. This guy needs to cut these guys off so they can't assist next time. You two, come over here. This is my guy. We could do something. Receiver? No. No. Mark the ball carrier. Doesn't matter too much if he hits me. Fair enough. 2 die there, but this is way more important. We need to knock this guy down. Otherwise he dodges and scores and the game is over. So definitely reroll, and we got lucky. Can pile on too, if we need to. Okay, let's go. Ball bounces loose. Could make 2 GFIs to pick it up. And again, we could knock this guy down. I'll take it. Not that I have a choice. Broke our armor, not his. Even though it was equal. Does that mean this guy gets free? Can mark the ball or dodge to actually pick it up. GFI to blitz a rocker only gets a push. Rerolls it to get out. You wanna follow that up and stand on my killer? Yes. I don't, of course. Didn't break our rotter. It's the hero hangnail, of course. Can't kill him. Nobody can kill him. He's almost got 50 SPP on a rotter. Granted, he has been relieved of line duty after he got his second level. And was our only tackler. And then he got kick, and that means he's definitely relieved of line duty. So he needs to cancel him and get another assist in here to hit the beast. I know he wants to hit the beast. He's gonna try to dodge his ball carrier over there now. He's gonna put a killer there. Let's a killer be hit by Mighty Blow in order to get... Oh no, he's hitting the warrior instead, pushing him away from the beast probably. Clever. No, he didn't push him away from the beast. No, he probably won't anyway. He's expecting him to be removed so he can't just stand up and activate the beast. But he didn't even break armor. Double three. 1-2-1-2. That's our pickup rolls that he just got on that hit there. Oh, he tries to dodge this war carrier, fails to dodge. He already rerolled something this turn. It was this push here, right? So our ball carrying goat can reach it now. We can foul this fella. Our foul is in range. Our killer is here. Could blitz him, not the best target, but the only one we can reach really. Where is it? All his players? We got four up here. One on the floor there, one on the floor there. So seven. Yeah, that's actually seems right. Might hit him. Well, it's kind of valuable to just stand there. Could stand here. Get some guard in on him. It's not terrible. This guy stands up first. Then we blitz. Then we blitz the ball. This guy. Don't really want to pile on here. A knockdown would be nice. Okay, now we need to be better about protecting the ball. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I guess this is rather safe. I'm gonna put him here and then foul from here, I think. Alright, you should definitely come back. Or do I want you up here? No, you need to come back and mark this guy. Beast hit, pick up GFI. Pick up GFI. You got it. We have to use this reroll. So now we want to do that. 83%. Do we trust the beast to not mess that up? No, I think we foul first. Just a stun is okay, even if this guy gets sent off. 83% chance to succeed. We don't want him to be able to put our ball carrier away. Stun and sent off. I guess I asked for it. Goodbye, poopsucker. He definitely did his job this game. Removed a warrior permanently from the game. And then he managed to stun this killer now. We only have 4 turns to get up the field though to tie this game up. The guard here makes it so he can't hit this guy. He's stuck on the beasts. This guy has a one die. Try to dodge him. He's gonna dodge, well, unlikely to get there. He's gonna hit the beast with a one die successfully. Breaks armor. It's a stun, piles on. Good. All the removals he got in the first half, he doesn't get this half. But now this guy's free. Good foul. Or he could go in here to assist. That's only a one die though. But down there, there would also be a one die. Well, that wouldn't even come from the one though. Okay, it's a one die push. It wasn't a warrior I removed, it was the Minotaur. I remember now. Yeah, so he can come over here. It's gonna take a hit on him. Looks like he's, both in the first half and in this half, he's taking all the hits he can first, and then trying to get the ball. Foul appearance, saved. So we have to blitz one of these. Mark one. Are you free to move? You are. I guess I'd hit him. Let's figure this out first. Oh, you blitz up here. Sideline cage? Actually, no, don't blitz him. You mark him. Someone marks him, punch him. Could actually surf him after that. So who marks him? Well, it's going to have to be Hangnail. If this is a knockdown or stun, can't get up there yet, so I have to make the blitz first. Been kind of risky. Okay, we didn't get the surf. I'm gonna take the knockdown now. One, two, three, four, five, six, nine, six, six. Yeah, it's gonna be okay. Where we want to be. Still has two guys standing here. Don't really want to mark him. I'm gonna stand there, I think. Blitz there. Okay, and then we have this. Good. Break would have been better, but no. much easier to play when you're up. Let's see, we are down two, but up five. So we're up three. Much easier to play up three than down, what was it? Nine in the end? Going for Hangnail, he's figured out who's the star of the team. So piling on. Not piling on. That's weird. Why did he feel like... Oh, maybe he thinks that he needs to be standing to be able to catch us next to him. Fair enough. Could stand up here to have a hit on him. Instead he dodges out. Oh, he's gonna hit here. No, wait, he can't. Oh, he has to jump up. But foul appearance... No, he managed foul appearance. I almost forget about jump up. Oh well, it only cost us a warrior. It's not knocked out. He doesn't pile on the knockout, of course. Might be tough to actually get away from these guys. The beast would be nice if we could wake him up. One die push. Gets on the ball carrier. He doesn't have block though. Dodge around probably. Would you fail a dodge? Thank you. Rerolls it. Makes it. Well, interesting. Is he gonna try something with this guy as well? No. I think we need to get up here to activate the beast. It's a GFI. We need to get here to activate the beast. If he activates, then these guys probably can't do anything, but he doesn't. That means this guy is gonna get hit instead, which is terrible. Well, this is a 2-die, and he does not have block, but pushes are pushes. Now it seems like we won't be able to get anywhere safe. Push. Guess we do this then to get one guy up. We need to move forward. I can blitz him with Mighty Blow. Well, not Mighty Blow, with Strength. He can't catch us, so this guy can afford to move. He needs to be there. I'm gonna blitz him from here. That's 5 versus 3, he's not a 2 die. But I need him on here so he can't get past me. Fine. Seems to be his main way of attacking. He's rolling both down, both down. Maybe we get blocked for him next. That means there's a gap in the screen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's, he can't really reach that way unless he makes a dodge. Of course he's gonna make that dodge. Take a 1 die. No. Make 2 dodges, 2 GFIs with him to assist. There's the free hit he got because the beast didn't stand up. It's just another warrior. Stun, pylon. This is too far from the from the ball to actually be relevant, so you might as well pile on there. Oh, he was in range. Only makes GGFI there though, he's not hitting with him. Can he also reach? Yes, he can. Wow, that beast would really be nice if it stood up. Alright, that guy can't reach because he has movement 5. And I'm not in scoring range. I should have made a GFI last time. There's the dodge. And the two GFIs. And the two die. There's the dodge. Last reroll. We'll take it for sure. Makes the dodge, makes the GFI, makes second GFI, gets the pal. Ouch. That's game over. Well, depends on where this ball lands. Pretty bad of him to actually push us to the edge there. Really, definitely not allowed to scatter here. But the ball lands in that zone anyway. Another dodge, GFI, GFI. Not picking it up. I mean, this guy has a 36% chance of picking it up. You're willing to risk the dodge and the GFIs, you should try to pick it up for sure. Failed anyway. Could surf him, that doesn't really do anything for us. He marks him, okay. Bring an assist there. No one assists the beasts. Beast is not going to be relevant. I'm just going to try to stand him up. Who picks it up? Guess we blitz with you. You pick it up. You stay in front. You mark him. What about this guy? We need someone in scoring range. He's far away from scoring range. I guess you would be in scoring range. To mark with him. Can't allow this guy to be on his feet. Oh well, let's allow him to be on his feet then. And then we need to make a GFI. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2. We need to make a second GFI. So now we mark him. He has no rerolls, that's a positive. We need to pick the ball up. Scattered this way would be almost good. Gets it. Nowhere to go with it really. We could actually run in here and then toss it forward. We toss it forward here. I think we need to toss it this way. Too late. Well, I guess we get a pylon on us. But if he doesn't pick up the ball, we can get it with him, hand it off to him. At least, if he doesn't blitz him, if he wants to win the game, he should blitz him. But I don't think he can make himself blitz with a non-mighty blow pylon claw. So he's gonna blitz the ball instead. Gets it. Unknown. Maybe not. Okay. Works. So, how do you protect that? Marking him is an option. Getting this guy on the ball is an option, but I think he wants to score, actually. Really? Maybe he just wants to hit? I don't know. No, it's an easy handoff to two GFIs to score. After that skull. Hey, good work, Rotterdam Ron. Beast can't really do anything. Actually, he can get another. Well, he already has a stone presence on him. Not that he's gonna pass to him anyway, he's not in scoring range. And you don't do anything. So, all I need to do is this. Do you want to do anything else first? Could take a mighty blow with guard here, that's not too bad. Also, that's his only scoring threat, so that helps. It is only a 1 in 36 of failure. Didn't work very well, but it worked. Okay. Pick up, of course, is a 1 in 9. Made it. Handoff is a 1 in 9 with the reroll. We'd like to save the reroll. And then two GFIs with our killer, one at a time. Fails the first. Reroll. And the second is good. Okay, well, we got this tie. It was a bit close. His score was much more comfortable than ours. Didn't get our warrior back this time, but I'd say we dealt more damage. Strange, because I was going for the win, and he was going for damage, and we dealt all the damage, and he got closer to the win. Okay, well, he has his guy back finally. Only one though. Who do we want to sacrifice? More thumb. We said Rotterdam Ron gonna be on the line, and then the beast, I suppose. And the rest of them should be back here. I'd like to put this guy on the bench in case of throwing a rock. No substitutes remaining. Our armor held up very well. But there was too many knockouts in the first half for us to stand up to his drive. On our drive we got a little bit unlucky, I should say. But we still managed to score in the end. Another kick. Maybe I should intentionally kicked it. Oh, we gained a turn. That's what we wanted in the first half. So we can still score then. Is he set up for it? Not really. This is his only scoring option. I guess he could make many GFIs for the Chaos Warrior. And he doesn't care, he wants to hit. This team is only built for punching. Both of them wrong. He's gonna pile on knockouts now, so we know there's a pile on coming. Stunned him, it means he can be fouled. Knockout would have been better. That's only one assist. He's gonna have to hit the guy on the other side first. That's not gonna help. We need to assist on the. There we go. Sore Thumb has spent the game on the bench, so he hasn't been knocked out yet. There he goes. First punch. Knocked out. You know the pylon is coming. Oh, decay. He had to roll twice. Miss next game. Okay, that's not too bad. So all that's left is the beast. He needs one more assist to be able to hit with Mighty Blow here. With a 2. I guess he doesn't have anyone with Claw left. We managed to get 2 of them. I don't think we dealt any permanent injuries though. Keep waiting for server, waiting for opponent. Did we both disconnect? That seems fishy. Did the server go down? It isn't my connection. Well, hopefully this doesn't mean that we lose the game. Maybe the server went down. Blood Bowl server. That would explain why both of us disconnected. But it wouldn't explain why the server noticed both of us disconnected and relayed that information to us before we actually disconnected. Let me quickly just check that I have internet connection on my side. Yes, I do. So all we can do is wait. Well, I'll pause the video, I suppose, and bring it back when the server goes back up. Okay, well, we're back. This is the same hit as before. He's gonna pile on and he's gonna take this next game. And we still can't do anything about that. And now he's gonna hit the beast. But he wants the foul too. He's gonna give up the foul to hit the beast. Sacrifices we all have to make. Gets it. And now no one can foul the beast. He can make a pass though. There's a disturbing presence there, so the catch is not gonna be easy. Oh, right, I forgot. Never mind. We actually have another turn. So, yeah. Let's try to blitz with the beast. One die. Hook him down. Haha, we stunned one. No point in doing anything else. We could actually. This might be a good idea to try to fall over. Run! Okay. He didn't fall over. Maybe we should have gone into attack the zone and tried to dodge. That would have fallen us over. Well, he would have just stomped on us anyway with dirty play. That's actually worse. Probably better to be on our feet. Do you want to run up there and try to prevent him from getting assists enough to hit us? But then he hits those players instead. I'd rather him hit the beast. So here we go. Another hit. We're too far away for him to hit us without GFIs from both his pylon guys. I'm pretty sure he'll do a GFI with one of these, probably the pro one, because that'll give you a reroll. Actually, Frenzy would give you another chance as well. Makes it on the first. We won't use the stand firm, so I get further away. His pylon, I mean his foul is further away. Maybe he can't get all the assists in there. Pylon is probably... knockout, okay, no foul then. That means 4 strength Rotter is getting fouled. Make the pass first to get another assist. No, foul first. No. No pass. Foul's more important. Get this Rotter out of there. Knocked out. Great. Well, that's the game. It's a draw. Even though we gave these guys a pretty hefty handicap, or advantage by having tons of money that we didn't use, it still ended in a draw. And we didn't get enough. We can't really get enough unless our opponent concedes. So we have to hope that someone concedes to us. If you want this to happen, you should probably just concede your games if they don't concede, until someone concedes to you pre-kickoff, and then you can get the treasure in. But that seems a little bit dull. We lost some fan factor, that's good. We got the Nurgle Warrior level up, that's even better. 39 armor breaks versus 13. 12 knockouts, 3 injuries. Only one of them not regenerated, that was a Rotter on turn 15 when the game was over. Equal number of bro. Equal number of blocks. He has 39 armor breaks in 40 blocks. What? Is that even possible? Was every block he made an armor break except one? That can't be right. Didn't feel like that. I mean, successful is this counts pushes as well, and he had some pushes. I think something must be wrong at least. I'm thinking now. He did pile on almost every time. But surely there was more than once that our guy didn't get an armor break. I can't believe that. 39 is probably wrong somehow. Oh, maybe armor breaks. This probably counts it twice when you pile on. If you get an armor break on the first hit, it counts it once, and then when you pile on, it counts another armor break. That's probably what happens here. So his pylons, when he gets armor break on the first hit, the pylons count twice here. That'll make it probably good. But still, that's a pretty good ratio. 39 out of 40 armor breaks, and still we managed to deal more injuries. Because the foul counts. It doesn't count as an injury inflicted. but it does count as a casualty sustained. Anyway, Pale Pony with all the SPP. Yeah, he scored a touchdown too, I remember. So three injuries and one touchdown, Pale Pony. He's almost as much of a star on the team as Hangnail. That was a pretty annoying game. Pretty risky to play this much above our actual team value. But it was fun. We got a bit lucky, I'd say. We didn't get a bunch of injuries in the first half instead of knockouts. But if we had had... if we had won the coin toss and had our second half as the first half, then his second half would not have been as good, because he would have had, what was it, five guys injured? We had one at the end of the first half. At the end of the second half. So yeah. But it was nice to play a full game at least. Hope you enjoyed the match. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you again next time.